In this tutorial, we shall discuss the concept aggregate demand. At the outset, you must understand the word aggregate is always used to refer a value which represents the nation as a whole. On the one hand, nation produces the output, and on the other hand, it generates demand for that output. Of course, both are performed by different sections of the people living in the same nation. So, it becomes necessary for us to probe into the link between national income and the output people plan to buy. Let me make it clear with the help of this graph. Along the x-axis, the national income is measured. Along the y-axis, aggregate demand, otherwise known as aggregate expenditure, is measured. The curve AD represents aggregate demand. The aggregate demand is all about the relation between nation's output people plan to buy and the nation's income. Take a point on the curve, say H. Travel vertically down to x-axis. It represents 100 rupees income. In our discussion, the word income normally refers to national income. Okay. Travel horizontally to the y-axis. It represents 90 rupees aggregate expenditure. In this curve, there is no reference to output. This aggregate expenditure actually represents the money value of output that is likely to be bought when the income is 100 rupees. So, the best way of understanding the point H is that when the nation's income is 100 rupees, the community is willing to buy output worth 90 rupees. From this, it follows that each point on the aggregate demand represents a certain level of money value of output the community as a whole plan to buy at different income levels. Having laid a strong foundation like this, let us proceed to define aggregate demand. Aggregate demand function refers to different output the community as a whole plan to buy at a different income during a given period of time. With this understanding, we shall proceed to discuss the various components of aggregate demand. Aggregate demand is the sum of private consumption expenditure, investment expenditure, government expenditure, and net exports. Let us see them one by one. Private consumption expenditure. In the graph, C represents consumption function. It is that part of output of the economy the household sector plans to buy. The output consists of all types of goods, durable, non-durable, and services. Consumption is a function of income. The shape and position of the curve is determined respectively by marginal propensity to consume and autonomous consumption. Consumption curve starts somewhere along the y-axis. In our graph, it starts at A. A is autonomous consumption. It is independent of income. It determines where the consumption curve to start along the y-axis. The MPC is the slope of the consumption curve. Since MPC is constant, the consumption curve has a uniform slope. Investment. In the graph, I represents investment function. Investment is that part of the output of the economy the investing community decides to buy. It consists of physical capital like machineries, raw materials, etc. There are two types of investments, induced investment and autonomous investment. The curve I represents autonomous investment. It is horizontal and parallel to x-axis. It means the investing community plan to invest a fixed amount irrespective of changes in income. Investment is a function of rate of interest. By vertically adding investment expenditure with consumption expenditure, we get the C plus I curve. Since a fixed amount is added to the consumption, C plus I curve is parallel to consumption curve C. In a two-sector model economy, it is the aggregate demand curve. Government expenditure. Curve G represents government spending. Government spends on consumption as well as on investment. It spends on consumption goods like defense, maintenance of law and order, education, healthcare, etc. On the investment side, it spends mostly on heavy industries and infrastructure like construction of roads, irrigation facilities, building dams, etc. Its expenditure is mostly governed by its own policies. It is also independent of income. Since government decides to spend a fixed amount, the curve G is parallel to x-axis. By vertically adding government expenditure with the C plus I curve, we get the curve C plus I plus G. This is the aggregate demand curve of three-sector model. Net exports. Curve X minus M represents net export expenditure. It is yet another component of aggregate demand. Foreigners spend on domestically produced goods. Domestic people spend on foreign-made imported goods. The difference between foreigners' expenditure on domestic goods and the domestic expenditure on imported goods constitute net exports. This expenditure is also independent of income. For the sake of analytical simplicity, we assume a fixed net export amount is spent by the community in the economy. Hence, this curve is also parallel to x-axis. By vertically adding net export expenditure to C plus I plus G curve, we get the curve C plus I plus G plus X minus M. It is the aggregate demand curve of the four-sector model. Thus, aggregate demand is the sum of four components: private consumption expenditure, investment expenditure, government expenditure, and net exports. Since sum total of all the expenditure is equal to national income, it can also be stated as AD equal to Y equal to C plus I plus G plus X minus M. Our discussion on aggregate demand ends here. We shall meet again.